Hello everybody, my name is Sonia and I'm so thankful to be here with you today. I am going to restart doing videos. I had done them before, but I'm going to start them again with regard to a notebook. So this is a notebook, what I call a notebook. It was inspired by the Holy Ghost. And the purpose of a notebook is to give a quick message, just like what you read, what notebook means. It's a quick message that gives you a trinket of information or a nugget of some kind that brings enlightenment from the Word of God to the people. And I do have notebooks that are just written out as a post, but I really felt like the Lord wanted me to start this notebook series, and this is the first one, and I'm really thankful to do it. So in the past, I've done messages like a half hour, 45 minutes, an hour and a half long. That is where my heart is right there. My heart is with long messages that probably isn't for everybody, but just a whole study of something that the Lord would put in my heart to do and then give. And I stopped doing that for a while, to be quite honest with you. And here it's been maybe the last a week, 2 weeks, where I know the Lord has been he's been pushing me to do this, like to get back on it and to do it again. So I'm like, okay, Lord, I'm gonna do it. And so he gave me a little something in regard to a notebook. So that's what this is. And I'm just starting off with that introduction. And if you're asking, well, from where? It's from a channel that the Lord gave me called Eden Lif3 back in 2019. In September of 2019, to be specific. And so I'm gonna do this notebook, and I hope that they improve over time, you know, just like, I don't know, better quality and all of that, especially with the messages. Now, I won't be doing a message on like IG. That will be put on YouTube, and then those will be put on Facebook. But you know, then I'll probably do like a short clip or something on IG saying, hey, there's a message, it's called this, you know, check it out there, right? I do know that the next message will be about crowns. Then the one after that is going to be about liquid gold, as far as I know right now. Those are what the Lord has put in my heart. But today, this notebook is going to be about 1 John 5:14. I wrote it down because if I have the Bible in front of me when I'm out here, it's harder to read, and then I really don't have my attention more focused on you the way I want to have it. This is about the difference, quickly, the difference between asking the Lord for something that your heart is desiring versus going to Him just because you're knocking on His door and because you just want to be there, just talk to Him. So I'll start with 1 John 5:14, which says, now this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. Okay, so if we ask Him for something according to His will hear us. Okay, then Matthew 7:7-8 says, ask and it will be given to you. If you knock, I will open it for you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and him who knocks, it will be opened. Okay, so there's a difference here that the Lord wanted me to pinpoint for everybody. When you ask the Lord, right, you're asking Him for something that's in your heart. Like, Lord, I want that car, or I want that husband, or I want that job, right? And so you go to Him in confidence because you're trusting that you're going to a person, to a God, an entity that you can trust with your secrets, right? So you go to Him and then you ask Him for something. But the condition of 1 John 5:14 is that it has to be according to His will. And I'm noticing a lot of people are asking God for something because they're like, oh yeah, well, where two or more come together in His name, whatever I ask for, I'll get. If it's according to His will, you'll get it. And not just because you don't get it right away, it doesn't mean that it wasn't His will. It just means that maybe He's preparing you for that thing. So we have to be able to differentiate between what is His will and what is not. And if you're asking Him for something, whether it is good for you according to His will or not. And if it's not, being willing to be okay with it, being accepting of God's decision, because the Word of God says that His yeses are yes and His noes are noes. He's never a medium person, you know? There is a difference between that and then Matthew 7, 7 through 8. Again, that says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened. Right? Okay, so why is it that God would open the door if I knock on it? Why would I find Him then if I seek Him? Right? But why is it that He won't, you know, give me what I'm asking for? Well, those are two different levels. You're going to a different place inside of Him. Matthew 7, 7 through 8 is followed by the verses that talk about that. If you go to your father and you ask him for a piece of bread, he's not going to give you a rock. Or if you go to your father and you ask him for something to eat, for fish, he's not going to turn around and give you a snake. The precedent of why you're approaching him to ask him for anything is different on Matthew 7, 7 through 8. That right there is talking more about your relationship with God, your ability to go to Him and talk to Him, and He will be there. He will lend His ear to you, His shoulder to you. He will give you your hugs every day. He will be everything you need Him to be, because He wants you to trust Him. And He wants you to learn to engage with Him, to be with Him, to love Him, learning how to do that, learning how to obey Him, learning how to include Him in every day and in all your major decisions and minuscule decisions. I don't mean like, Lord, what kind of coffee you think I should order today? He might tell you, but if He doesn't, don't worry about it. You know, that's not detrimental. But there's a difference between that and then saying, Lord, I want X, Y, and Z. And He says no, or He says yes. You're asking Him, you're petitioning something for a reason. Like if you go to court and you file paperwork and you're asking for something specific, permission from the judge to grant you. That's a little different than just going to His house and spending time with Him, or needing to talk to Him about your woes, your problems, how you feel that day, how somebody made you feel, how somebody talked to you, how maybe you did something stupid and you needed to go to Him and say, Lord, I'm sorry, or whatever. You know, that's a different area of the Lord. And so I'm noticing a lot of people going to Him and saying, having a false idea that when you ask Him for something, that you're automatically going to get it. And if you don't get it, then He doesn't love you. And that's where the enemy comes in and tries to say, see, He's not listening to you. See, he doesn't care. Well, we need a little bit of understanding. 1 John 5:14, what you ask Him has to be according to His will, because He knows what's best for you. Don't be afraid to ask Him though. And then Matthew 7, 7 through 8, you're going to that shelter place with Him. He's opening the door because you're His child. Now when you're in there, you want to ask Him for something specific, go for it. He wants to grant you the heart desires that you have. So I hope I made that clear, the difference between asking for something that isn't His will versus knocking on His door, seeking Him, just to be with Him. And I hope I made that clear to everybody. That's something that I've just noticed a lot of believers who have been around for a minute, like they just have that false idea that God's just going to give them whatever they want. And if they don't get it, they get mad. And that's not right, saints. That's not cool right there. We gotta humble ourselves to the Lord and accept the decisions that He has placed for our life, because He's predestined us already. He knows what's good for us and what's not. And so, believe me when I tell you, if it's not His will, He's gonna close that door. You can kick it down, it's not gonna open, because He knows that what's on the other side of that isn't gonna be good for you. He cares for you that much. He cares for you very much. So, that's it. That's my first notebook. It's outside. I'm a little cold, whatever, but that's fine. And I hope you enjoyed that. So, God bless you. I'll see you later. Bye.